Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel, Lives of My Creative. I am doing a step-by-step tutorial today on my shine design. If you follow me on my socials, you've seen this design before. But before I get into the tutorial, I just wanted to make an announcement. I have launched my first product on my website. I will link it down below so you can check it out. But make sure you give this video a big thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and let's get right into it. I'm starting with a blank canvas. At the bottom there, you'll see the color codes that I used in this design along with the font that I used. So using the text tool, I'm going to write out the word shine, and then I'm going to select the font that I use, which is Alternative Gothic number 2D. I'm then going to hit Shift Command O on my keyboard to outline the font. So now it will be a shape. I'm then going to right click on the shape and go to ungroup. I'm then going to use the direct select tool, which is on the left hand side there. I'm then going to swipe over the top of my eye to select the points that I want to move. So if you look here, the two top points are blue and the bottom ones are white. So that means that the blue ones are selected. So I can move those individually. So what I'm going to do is just click and drag up with my mouse, and you'll see that I can extend the eye. I'm now going to create the circle for the sun. So what I'm going to do is go over to the left hand side and click the ellipse tool. I'm going to hit shift on my keyboard and then drag out with my mouse to create a perfect circle. I'm now going to bring some rulers down. So I'm going to hit command R on my keyboard to open up the rulers. And then I'm going to drag down with my mouse a guide. I'm then going to select the top of the N with the direct select tool. And same with the top of the H, just like I did with the I. And I'm going to drag up those two pieces to the ruler so they're aligned. I'm going to do the same thing with the E. I'm going to drag over with the direct select tool the area I want to move, and I'm going to drag up. I'm also going to bring down another ruler so I can extend it a little bit farther past the N and the H. The S I'm going to treat a little bit differently, so I'm going to drag over the bottom of it with the direct select tool and hit Command C and Command V to paste. I'm then going to bring down another ruler so I know where to line it up on the bottom correctly. I'm then going to just move it over to align with the other letters. I'm then going to hit Command C and Command V on my keyboard to copy and paste, and then rotate it and align it with that top ruler. I'm then just going to use the rectangle tool and create a rectangle to complete the part of the S that is incomplete. Once I have completed the S with the rectangle, I'm going to select everything with my mouse and then go to the Pathfinder tool and hit Unite. I'm then going to change all of my letters to the yellow. I'm now going to make the sun rays. I'm going to use the pen tool and create a straight line. I'm then going to click that line and duplicate it. So I'm going to hit Shift Command Alt on my keyboard and drag up to duplicate. I'm then going to use the direct select tool and drag down that top node to make a smaller line. I'm going to duplicate that second line. I'm going to select all the lines and then hit Command G on my keyboard to group them. While the lines are still selected, I'm going to go up to Effect, Distort and Transform, and then Transform. And then you can copy the settings that I'm going to do in this box. I'm just going to basically make copies of the line and make them so they're in a circle, just like this. And then once I'm done with the settings, I'm going to hit OK. And then I'm going to go up to Object, Expand Appearance. I'm going to right-click on it and hit Ungroup. I'm then going to select the lines again and then right click on my mouse and go to Transform, Transform Each. Then you can copy the settings here that I have and then make sure you hit Random at the bottom there because it'll randomize the lines. Then you'll get this sunburst effect. I'm going to move it over and move it to where I want it to sit. I'm going to put it behind the circle obviously. So I'm just right clicking and then going down to Arrange and Send to Back. Just going to move it around to where I think it'll look best. I'm then just going to select the lines and color it the orange color. I'm then going to select the lines again and go up to Object, expand and hit OK. And then I'm going to go to the Pathfinder tool and make sure everything's united. I'm now going to make the negative space between the word shine and the sunburst. So what I'm going to do is make sure that the shine is all grouped and then go up to object and go down to path. And then I'm going to go to offset path and I'm going to use the default settings that pop up and hit OK. I'm just going to color that offset path blue so we can see it. I'm going to select that path and the sunburst. Go to the Pathfinder tool and hit minus front, and you should get that negative space. And then I'm just going to use a rectangle and create the box in the background. And then you will have your final design. If you've watched this far into the video, thank you so much. I appreciate all the support on my channel. Make sure you give this video a big thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you in the next one.